Hi guys, my name is Sarah. As you know, if you are subscribed to my channel, if you could hit the like and subscribe button. So today, I'm going to be talking about Chime. I've seen a lot of videos. Last night I observed that there's a lot of people that have gotten scammed, and I would like to put my story out there. So, I have Chime with banks, I have banked with Chime, which is actually not a bank, I found out, unfortunately, but I was calling it a bank the whole time. I have banked with them since April. I do receive Social Security disability, so that money is pretty important to me because I can't go out and work like a regular job like everybody else. So I get like under $900 a month, so it's very important that, you know, I have my rent and my stability. Well, since April, I was getting my check even sometimes 2 or 3 days early. Sometimes earlier than that, it was great. I got my money sooner. It really helped get money sooner so I could have food and, you know, pay my rent and get that out of the way. So here comes November. So November is when it started, which is this month. So I was waiting for my check, my November check, and I didn't get it. Is very weird. I did not get no warning. I did not get anything that was indicating that they were going to keep my money, or they weren't going to give me my money, or they were going to send it back. So on November 3rd, I called Social Security Administration. I said, hey, I didn't get my check. And they're like, well, we sent it. So I went on my Social Security portal that you can have on your computer, and I looked, and it said that they paid me. It said my next payment was December 3rd, and I'm like, well, I didn't get my payment. So I called Chime, and I asked them, and I tell them, you know, what's going on and stuff, and they said they never got a direct deposit transaction from Social Security Administration, and I said, you guys are lying, because they said they did over the phone. And also, I have proof in my Social Security portal they did pay me. So it was just a back and forth, back and forth. I was getting pretty upset at this point because my money was lost. It was nowhere to be found, and I was pretty upset about it, as anybody would be if their money was just with no warning. And you need to pay your bills, you need to pay your rent, you know, adulting life. So I kept calling back and forth. I was so upset. I was getting so angry like anybody else would. I was physically sick. I was crying around the house. I was just ultimately upset. And mind you this, a lot of people may know this, but I am mentally impaired. I was born with some slight brain damage. So, you know, that money means everything to me. It came from my mom, which was deceased when I was 4 years old. I am 30, so that would make it in 1994 that I was 4 years old. So that money means everything to me, and the fact that they were just saying they don't know where my money is, and that SSA said they sent it, well, it was all a big mess that didn't get solved in the same day. So it finally got solved, I'd say, about Wednesday. Finally. So I dealt with it for about a week, actually. So Wednesday to Wednesday, it was a week. It was a week of headache. So as, you know, the 5th came along, the 5th was the latest day that you could pay your rent without a late fee. So I still didn't have the money. I had to go to my landlord. I did probably the second day I was dealing with this, and I said, hey, my check didn't show up, and my rent's probably going to be late. And I was so worried I was going to get evicted. I was like, super scared, because I never ever not pay my rent. It was so embarrassing, like telling, you know, the landlord, like, oh, you know, I'm sorry, but I don't have rent this month. You know, how embarrassing is that? And when you pay your rent every month on time, sometimes early, and then all of a sudden, without warning, you don't have your rent. It was very scary. And like I said, I was physically sick. I was throwing up. I was having headaches. And if anybody has mental health issues, you know that physically sick is so uncomfortable and unbearable. And it was. I never cried so much in my whole life. Like, I was just crying, like, oh my God, my money's gone. I'm gonna get kicked out. I'm not gonna have a home anymore. I'm gonna have a bad rental record because they might have to start the eviction process, which can take forever. So, she said, it's not your fault. It's fine. Just whenever you get the money, just, come in and, pay your rent. And I said, as soon as I get the money, I promise. So I had to last week go make a physical bank account. So this is what I've seen is that Chime is not a bank. They go through Bancorp. And they're able to make the transactions because they go through a regular bank to make your transactions go into your Chime spending account or your savings or your credit, whichever one you use. I was only using the Chime spending because I did not want a savings. I'm not allowed to have a savings. I'm only allowed to have one bank account. So I went down to the bank or to a bank that I've banked with before, and they're very nice people. And the headquarters is actually right in my city, of the whole bank. And it stretches far into Oregon. So, I was very cautious about what bank I chose, especially after all this fiasco going on. So I went down there and I told the banker what was going on, and he said, just to let you know, Chime is not a bank. And you're very smart to come down here and make an account and try to get your money rewired. And I said, yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. So as soon as I get home, I call Social Security and try to change my account information. Well, they said that my Chime bank account information was off by one number. And mind you this, I've gotten my check since April and I never had any problems. I did not change the bank account number. I did not do anything. So Social Security was like, okay, well, obviously this is their error, and asked me, do you have another bank account that you can use? And I said, yeah, I went and made one today, and I was calling to give the account number anyway so I could get my money rewired. So, sorry, I just woke up. I might be yawning more. I'm sorry. So I called SSA and I said, hey, I made a new bank account and can you guys try to rewire the money before Monday? Well, they said, well, it's Friday, so it's not going to be until Wednesday before we can give you a check. And at first they said they was able to mail it. And I said, how long does that take? And they said, like a few weeks. And I said, oh, I don't have that long to wait. Like, no, I'm not going to tell my landlord I have to wait a few weeks. So then they said, oh, well, we can just put it in your bank account, give us the routing and the account number, kind of like what an employer does. So I did, and I sat and waited for the money to come in. Now, they told me, one person told me, oh, they were going to give me a paper check. And then another person told me they were going to put it in my bank account. I was so confused. So then I called again at SSA and they said, oh, well, when we have to reinstate a benefit, we have to send it by mail and paper. And I was like, are you kidding me? Like, I just want my money, Like, I know that they are trying to do the best they can, and I'm very fortunate. But, I don't have weeks to pay my rent. I only had until probably the 8th of November to pay my rent because my rent was going to be late. So I didn't have the money on the 8th. I didn't get my money until the 10th. So let's fast forward to this Wednesday. So this Wednesday, so Monday, Tuesday went around and I still didn't have my money. Obviously the weekend went around, then Monday and Tuesday I didn't have my money. And then on Wednesday morning, I woke up and looked at my bank account, my new one, and there enough, sure enough, was my money. I was so happy and excited because y'all, you do not know how upset I was. And I'm making this video to go along with Chime scams And I am probably trying to obtain a lawsuit from them because they almost got me evicted. They didn't tell me without warning, and I saw on many videos that the terms of service that I did not read, which is important to read, that they can shut your account down with no reason, and they will tell you no reason why either. Because I tried to ask why that, they wanted to send my check back. And oh my God, it was such a mess, and I'm really glad it's over. But long story short, don't bank with Chime. They're not a bank. They're ran through Bancorp. I even tried to call Bancorp, and they said they're not affiliated with Chime, which on Chime's website, if you go on their website, it says an affiliation with Bancorp. And it also says that they're ran by the FDIC. That's not true at all. They're not. Because I even called the FDIC, I called the BBB, I called so many places to complain and say, hey, you guys need to stop this business because they almost got me evicted and they didn't tell me without warning that my money was not going to be showing up. Like, I got no warning at all. If I got a month warning, I would already went and made a bank account. I would have already had this done by November, but I had no idea that this was going to happen. I didn't know that it was, it wasn't a bank. I thought it was legit. And, I had my money in there since April. And I was just like, this is a big, big mess. And it was. It was a big mess. And, like, at the same time, feeling scared, anxiety, depression, not eating. I didn't eat for days. Like, when I have anxiety and depression and physical anxiety symptoms, my appetite is nowhere to be found. And what I mean by nowhere to be found, which means that my body is so stressed and so physically ill that my appetite is not telling my body that I'm hungry. So, like, what I call it is my appetite was shot, which means that my appetite was nowhere to be found. I didn't feel hungry for days because I was so stressed. I was crying every 5 minutes. I was just so upset. So I hope I can get this lawsuit because honestly, disability is federal money. It is not, you go to your employer and you're like, hey, I didn't get my money. This is federal government money. So I am trying to sue for me having mental impairments, which I do because I do have slight brain damage and I suffer from many other mental health conditions and just bodily conditions like stomach issues, female conditions. I also have endometriosis, which I've talked about in my past videos. And I have disabilities and that's just the way it is. My mom was a drug addict, she was a drunk. And you don't get to choose your parents, you don't get to choose what they put inside them when they're pregnant with you, and it's not my fault. And I do get judged a lot because I do have mental impairments. A lot of people don't take me seriously. But honestly, I feel like I do have a lawsuit. And I hope that I have enough information to obtain for these lawyers that I found that were on these Chime videos last night. And it looks all legit, and you don't pay unless you win. So if you win, you take a cut, or they take a cut, which is fine. I totally understand. I don't like someone fighting a court for me that is not going to get paid because that's their job. Like they're an attorney. So it's kind of peace of mind that I'm not going to have to pay a lawyer. And if I win, I get a lawsuit settlement. But hopefully, I do have a lawsuit because I don't want this ever, ever. Ever happening to me again, and I don't want it happening to other people. So just be aware if you're thinking of using Chime, don't. Because what happened to me could happen to you guys, and it was just a terrible, terrible mess. And mind you, I did screenshot all the emails they sent me, all of, my Social Security survivor portal that said they did pay me on November 3rd. And my next payment was December 3rd. And then I also took a screenshot of my Chime bank account that I had. Now, I actually don't know if I have a for sure lawsuit because after I dealt with the whole fiasco, I just wanted to put it behind me. So I closed my Chime account. So now I may not have a lawsuit, but I hope I still do. But It was just a big old mess. So yeah, again, don't use Chime. It's not a bank. Use an actual physical bank, which I found out was so important. Because when this happens, you need to go down to a physical bank and say, "Hey, what's going on? I didn't get my money." Well, I hope this never happens with my new bank. I really hope it doesn't. And I don't think it will because, like I said, the headquarters is in my city. It's a big old tall building. And I live in a city of about like 20, 30,000 people. So it's kind of cool that there is like a bank headquarters for the bank in my city. And it's just down the street. So it's pretty convenient. So if I have any issues, I can just go up, to headquarters and say, "Hey, I didn't get my money." But I don't think that'll happen because this bank, they said they don't ever do that. They would never, ever do that to somebody. You get your money, you get your money. That, and they said it even gets processed the same day and you get your money the same day. We make sure you get it on the day you're supposed to get it, which I get mine on the third usually. So yeah, I just wanted to put my story out there for anybody who may be looking up stories about Chime and how much of a scam they are. And yes, they are a scam. I'm not just trying to, poke words out there, but they are a scam. So, yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you hit the like and subscribe. Comment below if you have any experiences or any insight or anything like that. So, yeah, I just want to put this out here as a warning. I thank you for watching yet again. You guys have a great day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.